In this movie, I will demonstrate how to calculate a resequencing assembly in BioNumerics. The first thing we need is our reference genome. For this example, a reference sequence was downloaded from the NCBI sequence repository. For more information on how to import sequences from online repositories, have a look at our video on the import of sequences from public databases. This last entry holds the metadata on this reference sequence, and the sequence itself is saved to the genome experiment present in the database. We will start a resequencing assembly on the preprocessed dataset that was used to illustrate the preprocessing. We can open the experiment card for the data by clicking the experiment dot. From the SRS report, some basic summary statistics on the reads are displayed, including information on read set size, sequence length statistics, quality statistics, and individual base statistics. From the sequence read set experiment card, one can easily launch analysis on the preprocessed data. Three analysis types are available: charts and statistics, assembly analysis, and metagenomics analysis. The assembly analysis can either be remapping of the reads onto a reference genome or a de novo assembly. Metagenomics analysis can include a sample diversity analysis or an identification of the operation taxonomic units against a taxonomic reference database. In this analysis, we use the resequencing assembly pipeline. A dedicated wizard will query for the parameters used by the assembly algorithm. First, we need to indicate the reference genome that will be used as mapping references. We add the correct reference by selecting the sequence in the dialog. Once the entry is defined, we only need to confirm the reference experiment type where the reference sequence is stored, which in this case is genome, and proceed. Two types of resequencing algorithms can be used. The first option creates a target sequence without inserts, resulting in a target sequence which follows the same frame as the reference sequence used. The second option allows to perform inserts on both the reads and the reference. In this case, the target sequence may differ by inserts and deletions compared to the reference sequence. In this specific example, we will maintain the frame of the reference sequence and choose the first option to create a target without inserts. The first step in the resequencing assembly is the alignment of the reads to the reference sequence. We can leave all settings default and proceed. Once the alignment of the reads is calculated, the mapping is assessed. Parameters used for this assessment are the sequence identity, the maximum penalty score, and the minimum overlap region for the alignment. Again, for this analysis, we can leave all settings at their default values and proceed. This page queries for specific information on paired end reads. Paired ends are typically used to optimize the assembly in regions with repeats larger than the read size. Otherwise, repeats longer than the library fragment size cannot be reliably assembled and will create gaps in the assembly. When paired end sequences are used in a resequencing experiment, more information on the inter-read distance can be specified in this page of the dialog. However, for this example, only single end data is used, so these settings will not be taken into consideration as no paired end data will be detected by the assembly algorithm. We can just proceed, confirm the target quality threshold, and confirm the target base callings. The resulting context will be saved to the same entry. The only thing that needs to be specified here is the sequence type where the assembled sequences should be saved. In this example, we will save the results to the experiment type genome. when we later want to be able to perform a chromosome comparison of our reference genome against the resequenced genome or initiate a SNP analysis, both genomes should be present in the same sequence experiment type. For this reason, we already save it now under the same experiment name. After confirmation, the Power Assembly window pops up with the resequencing assembly pipeline in place, and the calculation starts. In the tab Execution Log, you can view the current actions being performed. Once the calculations have finished, the assembled contexts are concatenated, and this concatenated sequence is saved to the database. For more detailed information, you can check our videos on the Power Assembly functionality. Note that if you want to run the same assembly pipeline on a number of samples, you can do this in batch by selecting a number of entries in the database and start the assembly simultaneously on all the selected samples. This will automatically generate an assembly project for each sample and execute these in batch.